women.
You did say you always dreamed of having a child. It's our secret crush show. But you're telling me that you're a homosexual?
Yeah, I'm gay.
Oh, and you're also gay.
Then, will Dick Dietrick run for president?
You've probably never even voted yourself.
I have too.
For whom?
Mitch November.
General Hospital's Sean Kane and guest stars on Nightstand.
Secret crushes. We've all had them. We'd wait for a girl after school, follow her home, stand outside her window at night and watch her get ready for bed. And then after she turned us down, we'd make threatening phone calls to her. Well, tonight we're going to bring some people out of the shadows and put them face to face with the people they secretly love, or more importantly, want to have hot sex with. Our first guest has never seen a talk show because she claims to have both a job and a life. But she's curious to find out who has a crush on her. Please welcome Elaine Moritz. Now, according to my notes, you are a stripper from Oregon who has both male and female genitalia. Is that right?
No, I'm a school teacher from Los Angeles.
I'm sorry, you're right there, yes. Yes, here you are. You're a math teacher at Sammy Davis Junior Senior High.
Yes, that's right.
And you're aware that someone has a crush on you.
Yes, I am.
And you know that person is here tonight.
Yes, I assume in a booth somewhere backstage.
Now, wait a minute, I thought you didn't like talk shows.
Oh, no, I mean, I don't. But my mother watches them all the time. In fact, I'm here because she kept bugging me to come onto your show. Oh. I got divorced, and ever since, I've been sort of really wrapped up in my work, and she's been telling me to quit grading papers and get out of my shell.
Well, Mom sounds like a wise woman.
Yes, she is. In fact, she's a very big fan of yours.
Oh, really? Yeah. We should have brought her down here tonight. You know, occasionally, we like to have somebody in the audience who actually watches our show.
Well, actually, she's right there. Yeah.
You know, I'm gonna do something spontaneous. Mom, would you come down here? Come on, give her a hand, folks. Right there, Mom. I gotta say, you're pretty young to have a hard-bodied daughter like Elaine. What were you, 12 when you got married?
Actually, I was 13.
So you waited. Why did you want Elaine to come down here tonight, Mom?
Well, after the divorce, I mean, she just crawled into her shell and buried herself in her work. And so when your show called, I just told her to go down there and give it a try.
Hey, wouldn't life be a little nicer if you all just learned to go down there and give it a try? Elaine, before we bring out your secret crush, do you have any likes or dislikes that we should know about?
No, I just want someone who's good, mm-hmm, and decent, and someone who wants a family.
Oh, so you want to have a kid?
Yes, very much. I love children.
Well, then this guy should be perfect for you. Folks, meet Elaine's secret admirer, Mr. Thomas Wagner. Class at Sammy Davis Junior Senior High, it's Tommy Wagner. So, Elaine, what do you think of Tommy? Is this a case of love puppy style?
Tommy, what are you doing here?
Well, I wrote to him, Miss Moritz. I really like you. I mean, you're totally killer.
Well, Elaine, you must be flattered to have such a younger admirer, and you did say you always dreamed of having a child.
Yeah, Dick, that's not exactly what I meant. I mean,
No, Miss Moritz, Elaine, please, hear me out. Okay, so I'm only 14 and you're like 31, and so I'm in your math class.
No, Tommy, it's just not right.
No, it is right. Like, if we hooked up, we'd peak sexually at the same time.
You know, that actually happened to me once.
I'd be like no other guy you ever dated. Honest. I want you bad.
Look, I'm flattered. Tommy, I am, but there's almost a 20-year age difference between you and me.
Well, that's true, but you know, in 10 years, Elaine, it'll be a lot less. So, Mom, what do you think?
I think she's crazy.
Oh.
Mother. Well, don't bother me. I mean, here you have somebody who's crazy about you. Someone who is young, virile, unspoiled, teachable.
Doesn't even drive.
Well, I don't need to. I have a great bike.
No, Tommy, no. I'm sorry, but no, no, definitely no.
That's harsh.
There you go again, Elaine. You throw away another good catch.
Mother, my car is older than he is.
You told me you wanted to meet someone that you could work with.
What would you, if you were in my shoes, Mom, what would you do?
I'd make him dinner and have him for dessert.
Mom, like you're hotter than Angela Lansbury.
Why don't you take me home and I'll show you my support thong?
Mom, you shut up. What are you saying?
Bake my cookies, Grandma.
I'll do better than that.
Mom, look, you're embarrassing. Tommy, I'll call your mother.
Let's go for a shake.
Oh, sure. Just think of me as a field trip.
Yeah. Well, Elaine, this is quite a turn of events, huh? The older woman, the younger man. Reminds me of that Dustin Hoffman movie. You know the one I mean? Outbreak. Remember Outbreak?
No, it's The Graduate.
Look. I know you're angry. I mean, who wouldn't be after losing a date to your mom? But, you know, this could be a blessing because now you know you don't want a younger guy. You want somebody more substantial, somebody more educated, somebody more taller. Somebody may be sitting right next to you right now. If you could get over the fact that you'd be dating a major celebrity. Okay, when we come back, one of the biggest male stars reveals his secret crush. You'll find out who it is when we come back.
Get Gallagher? You can be a guest on Nightstand. Give us a call at 555-DICKY.
We try.
Whoa!
Motivation.
Napoleon wasn't.
Thank you. We're back. We're back, and as the old song goes, Juan is the loneliest human that you'll ever know. But surprisingly, even lonelier than Juan is our next guest. He's a big star who has a crush on someone. He's on the hit daytime drama General Hospital. Ooh. Where he plays one of the good-looking alcoholics. That's right, it's AJ Quartermain himself. Let's welcome Sean Kanan. Sean, that's quite a reaction, huh? That show of yours must be pretty good. I really gotta watch it sometime.
You've never seen the show, Dick?
You know, I would, Sean, except on Tuesday nights I take swimming lessons.
Yeah, but it's on every afternoon, Monday through Friday.
Caught me? Well, so let's get to the question we all want to know. Sean, what kind of numbers are you racking up on the Babometer these days?
Excuse me?
Come on, you're young, you're single, you're on TV. Well, what's the most number of women you've had in one day?
Oh, come on, Dick. That's...
No, come on, we're both on TV. We're peers. What is it, 6, 7, 8? What is it?
Listen, I'm gonna let you in a little secret here. That kind of sex, it's very unfulfilling.
Uh-huh.
You realize basically that the women want you as a trophy because you're on television. It's not for me.
Yeah, tell me about it.
So I want something more than that. There's this girl, and she works in my bank.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't really get a chance to see her a whole lot because I'm pretty busy.
Yeah.
But every time I go in there, she's so nice to me. Check this out. I'll actually go in and cash my check.
Yeah.
I'll come back 2-3 times later in the week to make deposits just so I can see her.
That's really nice, isn't it? But so anyway, you're a big star. Why come on my TV show now?
Well, it's funny. She's a big fan of your show, and I didn't want to come on with the whole Hollywood star trip. And I figured if she saw me on the show, she'd know I was serious.
Isn't that nice? Well, Sean, she's backstage right now. Can you look in the monitor? Can you see? There she is, right there.
Is she great?
Yeah.
She's got the most fantastic smile.
Now, listen, Sean, I'm going to ask you to go around the corner, okay, so we can properly surprise her. It's called the ambush. We do it very well on this show. So just walk around the corner. Okay, there he goes. Give him a hand, everybody. Okay. You want to meet Sean's secret crush?
Yeah.
Come on out, Wendy. Wendy, welcome to the show.
Thanks for having me. I love your show.
Oh, really? Well, I can already tell you're a woman of incredible taste. Now, Wendy, you're aware that somebody has a crush on you.
Yes, I am.
Well, what would you say if I told you that this certain somebody is somebody who comes into your place of work?
He is?
Ooh, I see a smile on your face. Is there somebody from your job that you like?
Well, there is this one person, but, I mean, up to now, I always thought he was way out of my league.
Why? Does this person bring in a lot of money?
Oh, tons. I mean, he's in and out of the bank 3 times a week. But that's not why I like him.
That's not why you like him. Well, why do you like him?
Well, he's very handsome. He's funny. He's got the cutest hair, and he's got great hands.
Oh.
And best of all, he's this big, important guy, right? But he's not taken with himself, you know? He's real down to earth. I mean, he doesn't have to be nice to us tellers, but he always is. So.
You know, there is no sense in lying this anymore because your dream man is here.
No.
That's right, he's backstage, and he's got a crush on you, too.
Oh, my God. I don't believe it.
Yeah, well, no. Believe it because your crush is here. Secret crush, reveal thyself. That's right, Wendy. It's Sean Kanan from General Hospital, which I'm told is a really good show.
Hi, Wendy.
Hi.
Hi.
Come on, Sean, you can do better than that. Come on. So, Wendy, what are you thinking?
Well, I don't know what to say.
Well, you know, before you came out, Sean was telling us how he'd divide his checks up 2-3 times a week. He'd make his deposits just so he could come in and see you.
Really?
Yeah, I'd invent reasons to come into the bank. I'd buy traveler's checks, cashier's checks, money orders, pay federal tax I didn't know money on. It's like even when I wasn't doing banking, all I could do was think about you.
Wendy, this must be very flattering.
Well, yes, yes it is. But I expected to see someone else.
Someone else?
Yeah, Rusty, the armored truck guard.
You're gonna pass up Sean Kanan for Rusty, the armored car guard?
Well, no, he's not just any armored car guard, Dick. I mean, if you saw him in that uniform, I mean, with that sharp crease and walkie-talkie under his belt,
yeah.
And the way he handles those quarter rolls, I mean. I'm saying this on national television. Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Now everybody's gonna know. I'm sorry. I really should go. I'm really sorry. I'm sorry. I should go.
Oh. Sean, Sean, Sean. Doesn't your heart go out to that poor girl? Came out here and spilled her beans. Now everybody at the bank is gonna know. She's gonna be so embarrassed. You should do a general hospital like this.
Wait, wait a minute. You're actually worried about her? I just came out here and made a complete idiot of myself in front of a million people.
Well, actually, 2 million if you count the rehab centers.
Rehab centers?
Yeah, our target demographic is losers 18 to 34. But, you know, cheer up. There's got to be another woman for you.
No, I don't want another woman. I want Wendy, the bank teller.
Well, it's too bad. You're just going to have to make your deposit somewhere else. Oh, no, no, people. Sean Kanan, everybody, give him a hand. Okay, our next secret crush comes to us from right here on Nightstand. He's the costumer on our show, and he's got a crush on another staffer. Let's meet Robert. Welcome to the show, Robert.
Thank you, Dick.
So, Robert has a crush on someone, huh?
Yeah, I do.
And this person doesn't know?
That's right.
Well, why have you waited this long?
Well, Dick, it would have been awkward because we worked together and, well, also because I used to think the person was, heterosexual.
Oh, wait, so Robert, you're telling me that you're a homosexual?
Yeah, I'm gay.
Oh, and you're also gay. Very good.
What's the difference?
Well, if you're homosexual, you like men. If you're gay, you know all the words to South Pacific.
I guess I'm both.
Oh, very good, very good. So you had a crush on someone at Nightstand, but you had to keep it a secret because you thought that he himself might not be gay. Is that right?
That's right.
Okay, you know, Robert, I gotta tell you, though, I'm a little disappointed. I mean, after all, this is the 90s. People are more accepting, aren't they, right? You know? If somebody can't handle somebody being a homosexual, that's their problem. Now, this person you have a crush on, are you ready to inform him?
I can't wait to fill him in. No.
Robert, let's watch the language, okay? This is the 90s, but let's watch the language. Okay, so who is it you have a crush on? Let me guess. Is it Kenneth the makeup man?
No.
Is it Pedro the security guard?
No, it's not him either.
Okay, so it's gotta be somebody still in the closet. I know, it's Mr. Nipples in accounting. So who's gonna be your choice?
It's you, Dick.
Just want to be clear on this. I thought for a second there that you said it was me.
I did, Dick.
Well, that's very nice, but that's not really something
on,
that's
Dick.
In my ballpark.
Now, I had my gaydar on, and I got a really good feeling about you.
Well, that's where you're wrong, Robert, just as we might have been wrong in hiring you.
Go ahead, tell me you haven't had one homosexual thought once in your life.
I have never had one homosexual thought in my life.
Never.
Never.
Never?
Never, I mean never.
Dick. 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 Dick.
All right, all right, all right, all right. All right. All right, fine. Yes, one night the thought of Tim Daly from Wings did creep into my brain. I swear to God that was it! All right, all right, all right! Yes, fine, maybe Wesley Snipes one other time. But I swear to God that was absolutely it! Okay, okay, okay! Yes, I saw the film Priscilla, Queen of the Desert 17 times. Terrence Stamp was delicious in the role. But I am straight. I swear to God, I'm straight. Now, Robert, go backstage. Get out of here. I'm straight. Go to commercial.
Hey.
Hey, you can get Dick on the World Wide Web. Cruise on by.
Well, we had quite a show tonight. We made a 15-year-old run off with a woman in her 50s. We humiliated a bank teller and a big star. But then it was all ruined by some sick individual. By the way, if you're a costumer looking for a job, there's an opening here at Nightstand. Preferably, it should be a girl. A girl with big gazangas. A girl who will give me back rubs while I watch football. Because that's what I like, big gazangas and football. And drinks at my gun club, that's what I like. For now, I'm Dick Dietrich.
Hey, Nightstand isn't over yet. There's a brand new show coming right up.
Hello, I'm Dick Dietrich. Tonight on Nightstand, hot oil wrestling or politics? Which one's our topic? Stick around and find out. Good evening. Voting, the birthright of every American, a responsibility not to be taken lightly, whether the choice is for the President of the United States or, well, for the board of your local homeowners association. But are we a nation of educated, discerning voters? Our first guest says no. Her name is Mary Madison. She's a former political consultant who's written a new book that says American voters are nothing more than sheep. Mary, is that so bad? Anyway, Mary, you are a former top political consultant. You've given it all up. Why?
I love the action, but I hated myself for selling out. I was exploiting people. And now you can read about it in my new book, Politics as an Aphrodisiac.
Politics as an Aphrodisiac. I gotta tell you, though, Mary, I always had better results with ground-up aspirin and tequila. You know, you get somebody to shoot down 9 or 10 of those babies, you're gonna see some action.
Dick, I was referring to the lure of politics. I got hooked on it when I was at Wellesley.
Ooh, the all-girls college.
Yeah. You see, Dick, politics is very seductive. Yeah, I love the sense of contributing, of thrusting men into positions of power. It's almost orgasmic.
Now, you mentioned three things that caught my attention. Thrusting, position, orgasmic. It makes me wonder, at this all-girls college of yours, did you ever have any late-night parties where you and the gals are sitting around the dorm, maybe combing each other's hair, and maybe there's a girl there, maybe your name's Amanda, and she jokes about giving you a little kiss, and all of a sudden she gives you a little peck, and you giggle, but then suddenly that peck turns into a full-on open-mouth spit-swapper. Did that ever happen?
No.
Oh. Do you know anybody it ever happened to?
No!
Do you know any movies I could rent where it does happen?
No! Dick, Wellesley was a respected school with an excellent political science program from which I graduated magna cum laude.
Well, lordy, lordy, Miss Scarlett, one smart girl. I do so enjoy good banter.
Magna cum laude. Look how I just threw that all away.
Well, some people would say you didn't. Some people say you're very successful, especially with candidates who were never given a chance. How do you explain your success?
Sex, pure and simple, Dick. Once I tapped into that sex appeal, I could make any candidate come from behind.
Oh, no, no, people.
No, no, Dick, really, really, they prove my point. Sex gets people's attention. Sex sells.
Especially in this neighborhood. Well,
the paradox is I hated what I was doing, but the more sex I put into a campaign, the more successful I became, the more successful, the more I hated myself.
Well, you must have really hated yourself because you're very successful. I'm reading here. In 2 presidential campaigns, yeah. 3 senatorial, and 2 congressional campaigns.
Yes, and 1 gubernatorial.
Gubernatorial?
Yes, yes, a governor's race, Dick.
I'm sorry, Mary, the word is governatorial. Governatorial. Okay, when we come back, we'll continue our discussion of politics as Rush Limbaugh and Ted Kennedy will face off in a winner-take-all pie-eating contest. Stay tuned. Ever turn yourself down for sex? Give us a call. Mary Madison, who says American voters are gullible and have no interest in the truth. But my next guest disagrees with that. He's a pediatric surgeon who also just happens to be the president of my condo homeowners association. Please welcome Dr. Alan D. Generous. Alan, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Dick. I'm flattered to be here, considering our differences at some of our homeowners meetings.
Well, I still don't think my lawn jockey is as ugly as you maintain, but, and my February fees are in the mail.
Would that be February 94 or 95?
Touché, Al.
But frankly, Dietrich, I'm slightly confused as to why you invited me here.
Well, in her book, Mary makes a point about the principles of politics that apply whether you're the president of the United States or the president of the Homeowners Association. So what do you think about what Mary's been saying here tonight?
I don't share her cynicism at all. I have faith that the electorate will always choose the best candidate.
Well, maybe the electorate, but what about the voters?
Mr. Generous doesn't understand, and I hate this, that the voters, what they really go for is a first impression, a visual first impression, more simplistic slogans and sound bites.
Really? And you say this holds true in any election, a national election, or maybe even an election at our homeowners association, at the Casa de Tuna Estates where we live.
That's right.
Trust me, Casa de Tuna voters would see right through her propaganda. I'm afraid, Miss Madison, that your claims are exaggerated.
That is not true. I have won many elections for totally unqualified candidates.
Well, you should be ashamed of yourself.
I am, but what was I supposed to do? I was good at it. I could make a monkey into a front runner.
What about me?
Sure, I could.
I think you'd probably have better luck with the monkey. He'd certainly keep his condo cleaner.
Touché, Alan. But let's just say, for sake of argument, that I was a candidate for some office. How would you help me?
Well, like I do with any other candidate, Dick, by telling you what to wear, how to talk, what to say, and how to act.
You know, usually I pay a woman in a leather hood an extra $100 for that. I'm kidding, of course. So, anyway, Mary, just say I'm running for office. Just suppose this. Where do we start?
Well, probably with your appearance, Dick. I mean, the voters must perceive you as a leader, from your clothes to your speech. To your hair.
His hair?
Hair is very important to voters.
Miss Madison, with all due respect, aren't these things just a bit superficial?
No. You know, Alan makes a good point. What about the really important things in a campaign, like slogans? You know, what about campaign slogans? If I were to go into office, would I need one of those?
Well, yes, you know, slogans can be very effective, especially if they are very simple and they appeal to the most human emotions.
Mm-hmm. How about, I like Dick?
Certainly be short and to the point.
Oh, no!
I'm sorry, but I hardly think that a slogan and a change of hair could help elect a man who listed himself in our residence directory as a gynecologist.
Really?
That was a typo. Now, Mary, in your book, you state that one of the biggest negatives for a candidate is to be unmarried.
Oh, that's absolutely right. Voters don't trust bachelors.
Come on, what about Clinton?
He's married, Dick.
Yeah, right. But let's just say I was to run for office. So what kind of wife would I need?
Well, that all depends. What, you know, give me some input on your first lady.
Well, I can't remember much. I was 12 and she was a friend of my dad's.
I was referring to the first lady.
Oh, Dick. yes, of course, yeah. I'm first. You know, anyway, you know, we thought it might be fun to stage a little search for my ideal political wife. So Mueller selected three ladies from our audience that might exemplify the real types of first ladies you mentioned in your book. Sound like fun? Of course it does. let's give it a shot. Mueller, can you help us out here? Okay. Mary, here's a little material for you. You can read this for me. Okay. And let's give it a shot. Mary, help us out. And first lady number one, come on out.
Okay, our first lady. First lady is a modern woman who doesn't like the term first lady. She prefers co-president. Please welcome Hillary Mittweiner. First lady number two is the traditional type who can spend hours on the campaign trail and then come home and spend hours in the kitchen baking cookies.
And apparently eating them too.
First lady number three. This lady looks especially good. Looks especially good on your arm. She will take any position you desire. And is also an expert on international affairs.
Whoa, this is gonna be tough. I guess I'll have to ask some tough questions. Okay, potential president's wife number one. If you were the first lady, what would you consider your top priority?
Improving the plight of the homeless and education for the children.
Very nice. And number two, thank you for coming. Number three. What would be your top priority?
As first lady, my top priority would be to satisfy the first man.
We have a winner! Audience, what do you think? Mary, what do you think about my choice for first lady?
Well, personally, Dick, I think number one would have been a more electable choice.
Well, I guess I'll just have to sleep with my decision. All right, Mueller, can you bring those chairs back up here? Thank you. Okay. Have a seat. Have a seat. You know, Mary, I'm feeling kind of presidential right now. In fact, I'm feeling presidential enough to challenge you, Alan DeGeneres, or should I say degenerate, to the presidency of the Homeowners Association.
You wouldn't get a single vote.
Oh, really? Even after the members were informed on national TV of how someone as petty and unqualified as you has no business being in office, especially now that the good voters of Casa de Tuna finally have a real choice, a real candidate they can trust in Dick Dietrick for homeowners president?
What? Yeah.
What am I talking about? I'll tell you what I'm talking about. I'm talking about a night 6 months ago, a night when I was in the condo's communal jacuzzi, working late with my secretary, Ashley. Until a nosy little person came down and said, hey, do you mind turning off the jacuzzi? Some of us are trying to sleep.
That thoughtless jerk wearing a snorkel in the jacuzzi was you?
That's right. That was me, mister. I have to be up at 6 to do pediatric surgery. That was me who had just slipped Ashley her 9th aspirin-laced tequila cocktail. I was there, man.
Dietrich, it was 4 a.m.
Well, for some of us, maybe, but we weren't bothering anybody. But because of you, I had to turn off James Brown, gather up all the empty beer bottles, then I had to go to get a shopping cart to carry poor Ashley back to my condo.
And this is all about that.
No, it's all about America. Do you think we fought in the Vietnam War so you could take away my jacuzzi privileges? It's about choices. It's about kicking your butt in the upcoming homeowners election.
Do you really think that anybody would take you seriously as a candidate? You've probably never even voted yourself.
I have to.
For whom?
Mitch November.
This is absurd. Who do you think is interested in the Casa de Tuna Homeowners Association?
I am generous, and when I am, America is. Right? Yeah! And right now, America wants to hear you defend your record as association president right here, right now, in a debate.
What? I'm not gonna debate some third-rate TV star.
I'll have you know I'm a second-rate TV star. Right? Just like the people in the association are going to when they see me kick your butt in a debate.
There's not going to be a debate.
Why, are you chicken?
All right, I'll debate you, but if you lose the debate, you move out.
You're on, buddy boy. Okay, when we come back, you'll see just what a master debater I am. Stay tuned.
Conditioner with Glucosil restores your hair's natural shine.
Don't be bored. Call friends.
What's the number then?
891-2727-27.
Ooh. Wings, the official airline of New England, proudly announces service to New York, Boston, Nantucket, and now the world.
Due to mechanical difficulties, we are canceling flight number 25 to Boston.
Reliable.
Well, would you rather go home in a body bag?
And courteous staff.
Another satisfied customer, huh?
Wings, the world's least favorite airline, tomorrow at 8 on the Paramount Channel.
Welcome to the great Casa de Tuna debate between Homeowners Association President Dr. Alan D. Generous and the man who dreams of putting the condom back in condominium, the esteemed Richard Dick Dietrich. Question speaks right to the candidate's qualifications. Mr. Dietrich, have you ever hired an illegal alien?
Not for more than 20 minutes at a time.
Mr. Generous?
I had an immigrant housekeeper, but I sponsored her for citizenship and paid the taxes.
Very good.
Taxes which were too high anyway.
What does this have to do with a homeowners association?
Oh, quit whining and answer this question, Mr. Generous. Why won't you repeal the communal pool's no-thong policy?
Dietrich, have you no shame? The entire membership voted to ban thongs. 200-1.
Yeah, well, I'm dating better-looking women now. And if you dared to put it into a vote again, you'd see that people would agree with me.
Agree with you? The people at Casa de Tuna wouldn't agree with you on anything. They hate you.
Don't make me laugh. Why would they hate me?
Why? Because, first of all, you carved your name in the sauna. Secondly, because every time you have guests over, we find the pool furniture in your living room. Thirdly, because our women residents are constantly complaining about missing panties from the laundry room. What do you say to that, Dietrich?
He actually steals their underwear?
Oh, that's just for starters. He also sunbathes in the nude.
Oh, big deal. It's my private balcony.
It's not a balcony, Dietrich. It's an unenclosed patio on the ground floor next to the main entrance.
What does this have to do with being president of the Homeowners Association? Let's get back to the issues at hand. Yes. Now, you talk about home improvements, increasing building security, yes, and better ground maintenance, right, all without raising homeowners' fees. Now, based on these promises, let me ask you, Have you ever had a homosexual experience?
I can't debate this man.
What's the matter? Afraid to answer? Afraid to confront the real issues?
Then let me ask you the question. Have you ever had a homosexual experience?
Yes, but I didn't inhale. People of Casa de Tuna, I beg you, let's not settle. Let's just strive to be great. People, I scored 4 times 7 years ago. And I can tell you, we have nothing to fear if we carry a big stick. And if I'm elected your president, I will make sure that chunky women will not be allowed to wear those tight leggings in the workout room anymore. And from now on, every Tuesday night will be full contact bingo in the rec room. And I promise you that with this woman kneeling beside me, I will rise to new heights. And together we will bring our condo complex to greatness. Yes, I will. Because I am Richard Dick Dietrich. Ich bin ein American.
This man is a lunatic. He probably could be elected.
I want to thank you all for all your support. It's a very humbling feeling, and I truly appreciate it. However, during the commercial break, I received some shattering news. I learned that the homeowners board meets on Tuesday nights, which you regular viewers know, is also the night of my swimming lessons. So as of now, I hereby withdraw my candidacy for the president of the Casa de Tuna Homeowners Association. But don't despair. While I might not be in the running, I'll still be fighting for you, fighting for what we have started here tonight. And rest assured, because of what we've done, the sun will once again shine on some downtrodden homeowners. And happiness will reign from the pool house to the rec room, to the hot tub white with foam. God bless our condo. There's no place like home. For now, I'm Dick Dietrich. See you at the pool party.
Bobby Chariot here, top warm-up man, here to keep you laughing and smiling on the Paramount Channel between the gaps in the programmes and the breakdowns. Particularly appropriate for me to talk about breakdowns because recently I had a breakdown myself here. So now I'm separated from my wife, sleeping in my jag and on pills for my nerves, you know. Well, never worry anyway, that's what I say. Let the laughter roll. Let it roll. Or even start. Anyway, have you noticed, like, you go into a restaurant sometimes and there's a sign on the wall and it says, thank you for not smoking. And I think, but I am smoking. Yeah. Sorry, I get a bit confused now sometimes because I've got a bit of a cold, you know. And you know that stuff that you take, like that night nurse and that day nurse? I've been taking this stuff. It's called psychiatric nurse. I must admit, though, it's a bit of a lonely life, you know, being separated from your wife and your lovely kiddies, you know, on pills for your nerves, stuff like that. And I must admit that sometimes I have resorted to what they call recreational drugs. That's a stupid name, isn't it? Recreational drugs. What does that mean? They're made out of a swing. Anyway, the other week, like, I bought some drugs off this bloke. Well, I thought it was junk. Turns out it was curry powder. Well, I didn't know that. So anyway, right, I rolls it up and I smoked this curry powder, right? I smoked this curry powder. I went wallop, I went back out, and for 2 weeks I was in a coma. Anyway, on with the programs now. Here we go. Back here.